Brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be upon you. This video is educational, so please have patience with me as I go along. I encourage you to take some notes and verify them later with the scriptures. Among all the creations of God, man is the only one who has a soul. God also has soul. Our soul is created in the image of God. The soul is attached with the body. The needs of the soul are eternal and the needs of the body are temporal. A soul is similar to a spirit, but it is not a spirit. Soul will attain eternal life and or eternal death. Or we may say, it reaches either heaven or hell. 1 Thessalonians 5:23 says, man consists of a body, a soul, and a spirit. These three consist a man. But if a body has no life, it is dead. So also, if a soul has no spirit, it is dead. But if the spirit is united with the soul, it is a living soul, as in Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. Or we may even say that the dead is quickened, as in Ephesians chapter 2, verses 1 and verse 5. If a person is not sensitive to his soul and its needs for eternal life, then he does not have the spirit and he is spiritually dead. Jesus Christ told Nicodemus that he must be born again. Nicodemus was a master of the Jews, knows the scriptures very well, and has accepted the Lord Jesus Christ. Yet, he did not have the spirit. So, Jesus told him in John chapter 3, verse 3, verily, verily, say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. In verse 5, he says, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. In verse 6, he says, that which is born of the flesh is flesh, that which is born of the spirit is spirit. So, we see that a man is born first in flesh through their parents. Then he must be born again a second time in the spirit. John 1st chapter verse 13, they were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. So second birth is by God. But Jesus tells the man that he must be born again. So the responsibility to be born again is given to the man. God says in Matthew 7:7-8, ask and it shall be given you. Seek, you shall find. Knock, it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh, receiveth, and he that seeketh, findeth, and to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. So, God tells us how to receive the Holy Spirit. So, it is the responsibility of man to receive it. He says, ask, seek, and knock to receive the Holy Spirit. Our spirit, our birth is an event that happened on our birthday. But it is also a process. The process starts at conception and it is completed at birth. The same way, the spirit birth also is a process. When a broken-hearted sinner repents for his sins and cries out to God, God gives him his spirit. And the spirit of that is the spirit of man, who is the spirit of Christ, who is the candle of the Lord, who is the seed of God, who is the light of life. These are the names which is given to the spirit, which is given to the man. That is the spirit of man. This spirit is the first day creation of Genesis chapter 1, verses 3 and 4. Please listen carefully to what I am going to say. You may get angry with me for saying this, but please listen anyway. Now, the spirit of man is the Holy Spirit. If so, he's not God, but he just helps a man to become holy. But the Holy Ghost, who is the spirit of God, who is the spirit of the Lord, who is the spirit of truth, these are the names given to the Holy Ghost. He is God. So, the Holy Spirit is one-third part of a man. And the Holy Ghost is one of the triune God, The Holy Ghost is God, the Holy Spirit is part of a man. When we receive the Spirit in our soul, the process of born again has just begun, as a mother conceives a baby. But it will still be a long way to give birth. The Spirit has to mortify all the deeds of the sin in our body. When these are all complete, then God will come and abide in us. John 14, verse 17 says, "The Spirit of truth, he dwells with you, and he shall be in you." Verse 23, Jesus answered and said unto him, "If a man love me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him, and he will come unto him and make our abode with him." That is, when our obedience to God is fulfilled, the Spirit of truth, that is the Holy Ghost, comes into us. Then both Jesus Christ and God the Father come and abide in us. Now, God lives in us. The process of born again is completed by the living of God inside us. And now we are sons and daughters of God. One more thing. The process begins when the Holy Spirit comes into it, the process of being born again. For from this point, when the Holy Spirit comes in us, from that point onwards, we are godly-minded people. If we sin, we will repent and rectify it immediately. If we did not act properly and promptly, we may lose the Holy Spirit. That is why David cried out to God not to take away the Holy Spirit from him in Psalms chapter 51 and verse 11. But when the Holy Ghost comes into us to dwell, the process of born again is completed. I'm saying the Holy Ghost come in us to dwell. The process of born again is completed, and we will not and cannot commit sin afterwards. 1 Corinthians 2 verses 13 and 14. "Which things also we seek, not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth, comparing spiritual things with spiritual." That is how the teaching is the Word of God will go forth. But the natural man receive not the things of the Spirit of God, but they are foolishness unto him. Neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. That is, the natural man cannot understand the things of God. That is why there are thousands of Christians, even pastors, evangelists, and so many, who ridicule the gifts of the Holy Ghost. The reason is that they do not understand it, because they do not have the Holy Spirit in them. According to God, they are dead people. That is, they are spiritually dead, physically alive, but they are spiritually dead. That's why they ridicule the gifts of the Holy Spirit. But there are many people call themselves born again and born of the Spirit and continue ungodly life. How do we know the genuine from the counterfeits? The answer is simple. Look for the manifestations. Galatians chapter 5, verses 19 to 21. "Now, the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envying, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such like. Those who do any of these manifestations and such like them are of the flesh, and they are neither born again nor born of the Spirit." Jesus told Peter in Luke chapter 22, verses 32, "Peter, when thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren." I can tell the same thing to godly men. When you are converted, strengthen your brethren. Thank you for listening. God bless you.